Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here and in this video we're talking about square numbers. So, what are square numbers? Well, I'd like you to consider the following. 2 multiplied by 2, which is 4. 3 multiplied by 3, which is 9. 4 multiplied by 4, which is 16 from our times tables. Now I'm going to draw 2 multiplied by 2 for you, or represent it with a picture. 2 multiplied by 2 means 2 lots of 2. Here's one lot of 2, here's two lots of 2. 3 multiplied by 3 means 3 lots of 3. So here's one 3, here's a second 3, and here's a third 3. And 4 multiplied by 4 means 4 lots of 4. So let's represent that in a picture. One lot of 4, two lot of 4s, three lots of 4s, and finally 4 lots of 4s. Now here we have 4 circles together. Here we've got 9, and here we've got 16. Can you tell me why 4, 9 and 16 might be called square numbers? Well, 4 objects like this, 4 little circles, you can arrange them into a square arrangement. 9 you could arrange them into a 3 by 3 square, and 16 you can arrange it into a 4 by 4 square. So a square number is the result of a whole number and multiply it by the same whole number, like 2 multiplied by 2, which is 4. 3 multiplied by 3, which is 9. 4 multiplied by 4, which is 16. The next one would be 5 multiplied by 5, which would be 25, which could be arranged in a 5 by 5 square. And the one we're missing out at the start, 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. So these are the first 5 square numbers for us. Let's go on to see all the squares we've got to learn. And here they are. Now one thing I need to point out to you is something called power form or index form. 4 multiplied by 4, a mathematician can write that in a quick way. A mathematician can write that in what's called power form or index form as 4 squared. And 4 squared means 4 multiplied by 4. So in our table here, I've got 1 squared, which means 1 multiplied by 1, and I've got the answer. And we need to know all the squares from 1 squared up to 15 squared. So these are the numbers that we need to know here. These are all our square numbers. They are the result of taking a whole number and multiplying it by itself. So for example, 144 is square because 12 multiplied by 12 is 144. And 225 is square because 15 multiplied by 15 is 225. And we should know all the squares from 1 up to 225. So there are 15 different ones to remember. Luckily, up to 12 squared, all of these are in our times table. So we already know these because I've begged you to learn your times table. So there's only 3 extra ones that we have to know. 169, 196 and 225. And they're the square numbers. Now we know what the square numbers are, let's do some questions on them. Write down the first square, the 8th square, the 14th square. Whenever you're asked to identify square numbers, straight away along the top, write them out. 1 multiplied by 1 is 1, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4, 3 by 3 is 9, 4 by 4 is 16, 5 by 5 is 25, 6 by 6 is 36, 7 by 7 is 49, 8 by 8 is 64, 9 by 9 81, 10 by 10 100, 11 by 11 121, 12 by 12 144, 13 by 13, do you remember that? 169, 14 by 14, 196, and 15 by 15, 225. So I want you to be able to list them as quickly, if not quicker than I did there. So what's the first square? The first square is clearly 1. What's the 8th one? The 1st, the 2nd, the 3rd, the 4th, the 5th, the 6th, the 7th, the 8th, 64. Or we could have got it just by doing 8 times 8 in our head. The 14th square is the answer to 14 multiplied by 14, which is 196. There you go, done. Evaluate the sum of the 3rd square and the 6th square. Now the 3rd square is 3 times 3, which is 9. The 6th square is 6 times 6, which is 36. They've asked us to work out the sum of them, okay? And the sum means to add them. So if we add 9 and 36, we get ourselves 45. Now they've asked us the difference, so that means to subtract, between the 15th square and the 4th square. The 15th square is the answer to 15 multiplied by 15, which is 225. And the 4th square is the answer to 4 multiplied by 4, which is 16. So we're going to subtract those from each other and we're going to get ourselves the answer 209. And we're done there as well. Right, let's try another question. What's the product of the 3rd square and the 6th square? Now product in maths means multiply. The third square is 3 times 3, which is 9. The sixth square is 6 times 6, which is 36. We want to multiply 9 by 36. Can we do that? Well, what I would do is, using the distributive law, I would say that's 10 lots of 36, subtract 1 lot of 36. 9 lots of 36 is 10 lots of 36, take away 1 36. 10 lots of 36 is 360, 1 lot of 36 is 36, 360, take away 36 is 324, done nice and quickly. The quotient of the 6th square and the 2nd square. Quotient means division. The 6th square is 6 multiplied by 6, which is 36, divided by the 2nd square, which is 2 multiplied by 2, which is 4. 36 divided by 4 is equal to 9. And we've done. Let's try another question. I want you to write each of these numbers in the form A times B, where A is a number, but A is a square number, and B is an integer, so B is a whole number, not necessarily a square. So if anyone gives you a question like this, I'd always write the squares out. Okay, so the squares are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, 100, 121, 144, 169, 196, and 225. Okay, always write them out so you've got them at hand. So we want to write 12 as a square multiplied by another number. So we could write it, obviously, as 1 multiplied by 12. That's one way of doing it, because 1 is a square number. But we could also write it, let's say, as 4 multiplied by 3. They are our only options. Anything else would not. 9 multiplied by nothing gives you 12 if the other number has to be an integer. So that's all we could do for that. For 50, obviously, we could write it as 1 multiplied by 50. Could we write it as 4 multiplied by something? No, 4 doesn't go into it, 9 doesn't go into it, 16 doesn't, but 25 does. We could write it as 25 multiplied by 2. And 98? Well, yes, we could write it as 1 multiplied by 98. Does 4 go into it? Go into it. Does 9 go into it? No, 16 doesn't go into it, 25 doesn't go into it, 36 doesn't. Oh, look, but 49 does. 49 multiplied by 2. And there you go. Here was our A's, that they were our A's there. We found a square number, and here were our B's, the integer number that was left at the end. Okay, and that skill there is going to be really useful to us in surds later when we're simplifying surds. So just keep it in your head, we're going to come back to that skill later. Right, here's something else I want us to think about. Now, here were the squares between 1 and 100, okay? I actually asked you to also learn the ones after it. 11 squared 121, 12 squared 144, 13 squared 169, 14 squared 196, and 15 squared 225. But I want to point out to you something from our work on negative numbers. Negative 1 squared, i.e. negative 1 multiplied by negative 1, also gives us 1. Because a negative multiplied by a negative always gives us a positive answer. So make sure you go to the negative numbers section to see the rationale behind that. So this is really interesting, because 8 multiplied by 8, let's say, gives us 64, but negative 8 multiplied by negative 8 also gives us 64. And that's something I'm going to ask you to remember in the next set of videos when I'm talking about square roots. So just to point that out to you and use it in the following little exercise for you. Given each number in the square must be the same for each part, fill in the missing numbers. So what must go here? Now, a lot of students are super good at saying, right, 2 must go there and 2 must go there. But based on what I've just done here, what also could go there? Well, negative 2, couldn't it? Negative 2 multiplied by negative 2 would also give us positive 4. So never forget that as a potential answer in these questions. Yeah, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4, no doubt about it, but negative 2 multiplied by negative 2 also gives you positive 4. So on that note, what numbers could be here? Hopefully you said 15 multiplied by 15. I reckon you'd have got that. Did you also say it could have been negative 15 multiplied by negative 15? I do hope so, because that's something I'm going to rely on later when I'm talking about taking square roots. And that's it for this video. Everything you need on square numbers. Thanks for watching.